Good morning, church. Welcome to church online this morning. You know, the word of God says, let us enter his gates with thanksgiving in our hearts and his courts with praise. So right now, let us come together and thank God for all that he has done this week. Let us keep our hearts open as we enter into his presence this morning. Let us pray. Father, we thank you, God, for this time. We thank you for a brand new day today, oh God, that we can come before you. Lord, I pray that, God, even as we enter into your presence this morning, that, God, you will encounter us today in a fresh way, oh God. Lord, we thank you, God, that you can move in a fresh way wherever we are at, and that you are not restricted to a building, to a place. But God, we know that your presence is with us. And God, we thank you once again. We pray that you will be with us even through this time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Oh,
time. God, we thank you that your presence is here with us. God, we pray that you will continue to be with us even to the rest of the service. Because we know that God, you reign above everything, oh God. And that God, you are a great God. And Lord, we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank the Lord for the praise team who have led us in worship this morning. Thank the Lord for you too, that you are able to join us this morning wherever you are watching from. And we trust the Lord to continue to minister to you. We thank the Lord as well as we have eased into phase two of our circuit breaker. But as a church, we are not ready to gather just yet. This is because in the back end, all the staff are making all the preparation so that in due time, when we are ready to gather together physically as a church, you'll be assured that you'll be entering into this premises safe. And so in that regards, we covered your prayer for all the staff. Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, here are some announcements for the week. We thank the Lord for every one of you who have given so faithfully and generously. And we thank the Lord that God has offered technology to us so that you can give, as you can see on the screen right now, the various options for you to give online via bank transfer or even PayNow through your personal bank services. As some of you have done, by sending in a physical check. Do make sure they are all crossed out to Elim Church Assembly of God and send them to 1079 Serangoon Road, postal code 328182. Amen. And so why don't we look to the Lord in prayer as we worship the Lord in our giving to Him. Father, this morning, we are thankful that we are able to give unto you. And so I pray, Father, as we give, not only will you bless the gift, but you will use it for the expansion of your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen. Once again, thank you as you give unto the Lord. Now, this Wednesday, we will continue to plod on in our Miracle Moments service via Zoom. More important this week, all the more we need to pray for our nation as we enter into the polling day. And so we do invite you to join us to pray together as one body for the blessing of this nation to have a good government to lead us through this difficult season. And so why don't you join us? And perhaps you have yet to register. We ask that you will register through the app as you can see right now on the screen. And we make sure all the information will be sent to you so that you can link up and join us and pray together for the blessing of this nation. So join us on this Wednesday night. As mentioned, because of polling day being on Friday, this particular week, we will not meet together at the KSL. And so do take note, we will resume this on the 17th of July. We thank the Lord, the last 2 months, we have seen an increase of attendance in our KSL ministry. And so we ask for your continuous support in your various KSL group as you continue to attend them faithfully. And we know that the Lord will continue to strengthen you and also minister to you. So do take note, this coming Friday, we will not have a KSL, but it will be resumed on the 17th of July. Now, because in June we are focusing on family closeness, this being a brand new month, we will be focused on marriage strengthening today. And this is what we want to encourage you: build and strengthen your marriage by uniting against an adversary. You know, in such a tension circumstances where there are so many unknowns lying ahead due to the pandemic, this is a golden opportunity to rally as a married couple and function as a team. Husband and wife need to strategize to confront problem together. I'm glad to know God has brought a very precious helpmate into my life, and we complement one another as we work together as one. And in recent time, because of the circuit breaker, we spend so much time at home. God gave us the opportunity to talk through the progress of our children and make it as a matter of prayer. Now, if there's one enemy that we must constantly be aware, it's the devil who comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And therefore, this week, be alert, fight the enemy with the help of the Lord. As Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 12 tells us, though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strengths is not quickly broken. Enter into this new month partnering with God in your marriage. Amen. Praise God. God is good. Now, being a brand new month, we want to bless and also wish many of you who have celebrated, because this is the 5th of July already, or perhaps some of you are also celebrating your wedding anniversary. And so, if you are celebrating your birthday and your wedding anniversary this particular month, why don't you lift up your hands, or even between husband and wife, joining your hands together, and we want to pray a prayer of blessing over you. So why don't you do just that as I pray? Praise God. Father, we are grateful that we can rejoice with the many of our brethren who are celebrating their birthdays and their wedding anniversary in the month of July. We thank you for your faithfulness upon each and every of these lives that are represented as they lift their hands to you as a sign of surrendering, as they join their hands together as husband and wife. I pray that you will grant them a blessed year ahead, that truly, O God, as they continue to put their trust in you, and as they continue to hide under the shadow of your mighty wing, Lord, you will continue to watch over them. Hallelujah. And so, Lord, in the days, in the weeks, in the month ahead, leading in this new year, Lord, that you will continue to watch over them. You will continue to bless them. Hallelujah. So, Lord, I commit each and every one of them to you, knowing that you will hear our prayer in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Praise God. And so, on behalf of all the staff, we want to wish you a joyous birthday and also a blessed wedding anniversary. Praise the Lord. God is a good God. Now, today it gave me great pleasure to introduce the speaker. He has been my pastor all my life in Ilim. He was my youth pastor when I was young. He was our marriage counselor pastor when both my wife and I was ready to get into marriage. And now he is my senior pastor as we work along together here in Ilim in expanding God's kingdom. So it gives me great joy to pass the time to him right now. And so why don't you join me as we welcome Pastor Glen Lim.
Hi, good morning, church. I greet you today in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you so much for taking time to join us today as we worship the Lord together on this wonderful day He has created, and He has encouraged us to rejoice in it and be glad. And so whatever you're going through, God is with you, and God is here to speak to our hearts again, to challenge us, and to meet our needs as we cry out to Him and believe that He is a good God who loves us and cares for us and wants to help us. Amen. Before I share my message with you what the Lord has laid upon my heart for you, I want to introduce Pastor Damien Ng, who joined our pastoral team last month in June as the executive pastor of Elim Church. You know, 2 years ago, God laid upon my heart to talk to him about his call upon his life to serve God full-time in Elim. And as we talked, he confirmed that call, but then he could not join us immediately because of his commitment to his banking job for 2 years. And early this year, he submitted his resignation and was reluctantly accepted, you know, by the owners of the bank to release him. Pastor Damien attended Elim Church for almost 4 years already, and he has been walking with the Lord for more than 40 years. And before coming to Elim, he was actively involved in another local church as a leader for, you know, more than 20 to 30 years. At this moment, I'd like to ask Pastor Damien to come and say a few words. Would you please welcome him wherever you are? Come, Pastor Damien.
Good morning, good afternoon. As Pastor Glen has mentioned, I joined Elim staff on the 1st of June as the executive pastor, reporting to Pastor Peter Lui. Some of you may be wondering, what does an EP do? Well, for now, just remember three letters, F-A-O. Now, this means I work closely with the team to manage the finances of the church, to streamline our administration functions, and to support all the ministries, as well as to ensure the operation of the church is up to speed to meet the needs of our daily works and functions. For example, I have recently formed the estate management team, or EMT, with the help of Sister Jenny Su, the office manager, Pastor Wilson, and Brother Ting to look into the overhauling of our air conditions and other related issues. A little bit about myself. I've been attending Elim, as Pastor Glen said, almost 4 years. I'm hosting and running a cell group at my own home. I am married with one wife and two boys. The younger one is attending Elim right now, but the other one is attending another church. Now, I had been a professional banker for more than 30 years. And in the past couple of years, I have been pursuing my Christian education with the Biblical Graduate School of Theology. As of now, I have acquainted myself with most of the current team already, and I'm on track to meet up with all the staff members in order to understand and to help support their ministry developments. As of now, there are a few projects that we are working on already. One example is the Zoom training session to be held on the 11th of July on the topic of mentoring digital savvy youths, which we hope to roll out to our target audience soon. I'm excited to work with the team to position Elim to be a church that God can use powerfully to reach the folks of our community here. One of the important work we are doing now is to prepare the physical church to be ready for safe opening. Another thing we need to do right now is to help those members who may be challenged, or they may prefer to attend church from home. So we will be trying to help them connect that technical or technological bridge to actually be able to attend church online. So these are the things that we are currently doing, and there are others too. So we will be happy to have all of you contact me. I'm at church email. If you all know the church email, can contact me. So I look forward to meeting all of you in person and get to know you better. Thank you.
Thank you, Pastor Damien. It's so good to have you join our team. And folks, I'm sure you get to know him a lot more better. You have seen him around for a while. And we're just thankful that he has given his heart, his life to the Lord for full-time ministry here at Elim. You know, last week, Pastor Peter Louis preached a timely and powerful message entitled Any Time Now, to remind us and to also warn us of Christ's soon return. And in view of Christ's soon return, we were challenged last week to look deep into our own heart and to review how we have been living our life till now and to repent of our sin and reset our priorities and values, as well as to restart life anew, to live it to honor and glorify God. And of course, to be ready to meet God, our Maker. So in these last days, I believe to honor and glorify God, we must, first of all, like 2 Peter chapter 3, verses 11 to 12 said, live a holy and godly life. In view of Christ coming like a thief in the night, then everything will be burnt out by fire. The question is, how should we live our life? He said, live a holy and godly life. Secondly, is to live missionally for God, according to 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 17 to 20. So the title of my message on this Mission Sunday is Living Missionally for God. You know, for those of you who are watching this telecast right now, we want you to know that, you know, every second Sunday of January of each year and every first Sunday of July, we designate it as Mission Sunday. It's a time to challenge our members to get involved in mission works and to renew their mission pledges for the next 5 months. And that is from January to June and then from August to December. Every year we collect only 10 months of mission pledges, but we give up 12 months of mission support to all the various missionaries and mission organizations and Bible schools that we are supporting. Yet, till date, God has not failed us in our support for them every month, each year. And we're thankful that this is possible for us to meet our mission obligations to them was because of your generous giving and your prayer also. And so for this, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for your love, your generosity, and your kindness. And today is missions is Communion Sunday also, and I want to encourage you on this special Sunday, rededicate your life to the Lord and determine in your heart that I will live a holy and godly life with a holy mission and with a holy purpose and making every day count for Jesus Christ and His kingdom. Amen. Let's pray. Father, speak to our hearts again as we open your word to know how to live our life missionally for you in these last days. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 17 to 20. Let's read it. It said, therefore, if anyone is in Christ Jesus, that means one who have accepted him as Lord and Savior, abiding in him and, you know, totally depending on him for their salvation, guidance, wisdom, and empowerment. He said, that person is a new creation. That means one who is reborn and renewed by the Holy Spirit. He said, the old, the previous moral and spiritual condition has gone, but the new is here. That means with a fresh start and a new life. Verse 18 said, and all this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ Jesus and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. That God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against them. And he has committed to us the message of reconciliation, and we are therefore Christ's ambassadors, Christ's representative on earth, as though God were making his appeal through us. And so we implore you, on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. Amen. Now, there are three important things to take note of in this passage. And to live missionally for God, you must know, number one, is that you are a missional person. Verse 17 said, you are a new creation. That means a person with a new heart, a new life, and a new hope. God did a spectacular work on you and in you, so that today you have a new set of values and priorities. You are saved, you are set apart, and you are sent by God for his mission. And you have a gospel message, which we call the good news, to share with people. And you do it with your life, you do it with your word, you do it with your action. And you always will have a testimony to share with others. That means, you know, before you were a Christian, and now that you're a Christian, after your encounter with God, what has changed in your life? And people wants to know. And perhaps, like for me, I remember that I used to be a rascal, but God can turn a rascal into a radical for him and for his kingdom. Amen. Second thing, important thing to take note of in this passage is that you have a missional ministry. Besides being a missional person, you have a missional ministry. And verse 18 tells us it's called the ministry of reconciliation. Verse 20 tells us that you are now Christ's ambassador. You are his servant. You are his minister. You are his representative. And you must tell others what he has done in your life and what he has done for you. And what have you received from him? Eternal life, forgiveness, love, mercy. And you're responsible to tell others what he has done for you. And you are to invite the sinner to faith in Christ himself. Now you're wondering, how is that possible? I'm just a normal guy. I'm not trained to be a preacher. I'm not trained to be an evangelist. I'm not trained to be a public speaker. Well, you have a testimony that you can share. What happened to you before Christ and what happened to you now after Christ. And that itself is a very, very powerful word that can help people know that this God that you worship is so real, so good, and so close. Amen. And he, God, will make his appeal through you. He will be with you, and he will empower you to do his mission. So the third important thing to take note in this passage is, besides being a missional person and having a missional ministry, you have a missional message. And verse 19 tells us it's the message of reconciliation. In other words, you have a message of hope for the hopeless. You have a message of redemption for those who are away from God because of sin. You have a message of reconciliation, of being friend with God again, being restored back to him. We call that the message of restoration. Coming back to be a child of God in his family. And living missionally, you know, for God, start by understanding and obeying the great commandment as well as the great commission. Let's look at the great commandment. Mark chapter 12, verse 30 to 31, it says, love the Lord your God with all your heart, your soul, your mind, and your strength. And the second is this, love your neighbors as yourself. And there's no commandment greater than these. So to live missionally for God, we must first understand. Unless we love God with all our heart, soul, mind, strength, it's hard to love somebody else. And when we talk about loving God with all our heart, soul, mind, strength, we talk about loving God wholeheartedly and completely, sincerely and unconditionally. And we love Him willingly and unashamedly. We will not be secret Christian. When people ask us, are you a Christian? We say, yes, I am. We will not be an undercover Christian. But we will love Him unashamedly, holding nothing back, not even our life from Him. In other words, once we accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior and love God with our heart, soul, mind, strength, we're saying to ourselves, I surrender my life. You know, I my whole being, my substance and my resources to God. There'll be no turning back, no matter what happened to my life. There'll be no walking out on Christ when I don't get my way. There'll be no betrayal and rejection of Christ, you know, when things get tough. And there'll be no renunciation of my faith in Christ when I'm being persecuted. So when you say you love Him with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, you're willing to endure and persevere to the very end till you see Jesus face to face. Then you can love your neighbor as yourself. Loving your neighbor as yourself means you choose to be a blessing and not the bane to them. You do no harm to them. Instead, you do good and you draw them because of your testimony, because of your action, because of your behavior. You draw them to God. And that calls for us to live with a calling and a purpose. And what is that purpose? That is to fulfill the Great Commission. In Matthew 28, verses 18 to 20, Jesus said this word to His disciples. He said, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely, I am with you always, to the very end of the age. So all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to Jesus, and now He assigns us. Now He commands us to do this mission partnership with Him. To go. And I list all a few P's for you to help you understand easily. Firstly is participate. Go, He said. In short, be proactive. Be, you know, get involved in church. Be active and not be passive. Allow God to fulfill His will in your life, in this fellowship, in this gathering of saints here at Elam. And because all authority has been given to Him, He gives us this power before we go to pray, to preach, to proclaim, and to present the gospel with authority and with anointing. So go for what purpose? Go make disciples. Not just gather followers or, you know, get a crowd of people only. And the next P is place. He said, go make disciples of all nations. In Acts chapter 1, verse 8, it says, and you shall receive power when the Holy Ghost shall come upon you, and you shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea, you know, in Samaria, and the ends of the earth. So we go make disciples. We go and witness. First of all, in our home, we set the example of what a good Christian, a true Christian, a born-again Christian is. Especially if your wife or your husband, your mom or your dad, your in-laws are not Christian, they will watch you. They will watch and see what is a Christian. How will they live their life? And you are responsible to set that example. So you start at home, then the neighbors, then the community, then in your school, in your camp, in the workplaces, in your social circles, among relatives and friends, and then to the city, to the nation, and to the entire country. Not only local, but overseas. That as he lead us, guide us, just like some missionaries, to partner with him in mission work all over the world. So that takes us to pursue. He said, baptizing them. We pursue the people who have yet to know God with our example, our hard work, our diligence, with our good works, our behavior, until they come to not only know Jesus Christ, but to accept him as Lord and Savior. And to seal that with water baptism. And so don't give up praying. Don't give up witnessing. Because that would take us to persuade, teaching them to obey all things. Why? Because obedience brings blessing. Remember, obedience brings blessing to your life, to your home, to your family. And the 6P is promise. Because you're not going to do this on your own. Jesus said, lo, I'll be with you. Surely, I'll be with you till the end of the earth. You'll never walk alone trying to witness and evangelize. God is there with you and for you, and he will help you. Amen. So mission is a mandate. It is not, you know, a choice or not an option. It's not just a matter of personal preference or not an alternative among several things. But it is something we must do. So what must we do? If we truly believe that hell is real and that people without Christ are hated there, according to Scripture, then we should present ourselves as living sacrifices before God's altar. Ask God, take our lives, use us as his laborers in his harvest field. That we will rise up and not just live for ourselves, we'll live for his kingdom, we'll be counted for his kingdom. That we will be active people and not passive people in church. We'll get involved in the work of the kingdom, in the work of the church, in the ministry that God will lead you into, enriching out our community and our nations here. Secondly, we should pray for the lost. Besides presenting ourselves as living sacrifice, he wants us to pray for the lost, especially our loved ones, we have yet to have an encounter with God, our friends and our relatives. We'll plead for the souls of men and women. We'll ask God, be merciful on them. Give them a chance to hear the gospel. Give them a chance to respond before it's too late for them. And besides praying, we must preach to the lost also. We must grab every opportunity to witness to them and to share our testimony to them and to persuade them to believe in Jesus Christ and to accept Him as Lord and Savior of their life. We'll persuade them to taste and see that the Lord is good before it's too late for them. And then when they respond and open their hearts to God, accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, then we must place them in a God-honoring church for discipling purposes and equipping purposes. So today, join me in asking God for His anointing and for His power to live missionally for Him. Ask Him, ask God for His special covering, courage to reach out to the lost here and beyond our shores quickly. Why? Because time is short and Jesus is coming back soon. As we get ourselves ready to meet God, we want to meet Him with no regrets at all. So every opportunity you have, grab it and be a blessing, be a witness to those who have yet to have an encounter with Jesus Christ. Amen. I'd like to pray for you wherever you are right now, that God will just anoint you, God will just touch you, and God will just quicken you in a very special and powerful way. Father, thank you for my brother and my sister listening to this message, especially for those who choose to live holy and godly lives in these last days and to live missionally for you, knowing that, Lord, they are a new creation in you and you have given them a ministry of reconciliation and you have given them a message of hope, of redemption, of restoration. That you're reaching out your hand of friendship to those who have yet to have an encounter with you. And so I pray for my brother and my sister right now as they watch this telecast and listening, as they listen to this message. Father, I pray for a breakthrough in their lives, oh God. I pray, Lord, you'll do a deeper work in each and every one of them as you raise them up with your anointing, with your power to be what you want them to be and do what you want them to do. And so, Father, I pray every opportunity given to them, help them grab them to shine for you and to witness for you, that others too will join them, spending eternity with you in heaven. Thank you for your touch upon my brother and my sister, even right now, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. This morning, we'd like to partake of communion also. And we trust that you have the elements with you and you're ready as we partake of these elements to commit our lives to God completely. I'd like you to take out the elements right now. Communion reminds us of what Jesus has done on the cross of Calvary to save us and to set us free from sin and from Satan. Perhaps you are watching right now and you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior yet. I believe it's no coincidence that you are hearing this message right now. I want you to know that Jesus loves you. He cares for you. He died on the cross for your sin. He wants to change your life. He wants to do that deeper work in you so that you can spend eternity with Him in heaven. And today is the day of salvation. Perhaps you have heard of the gospel before, but you have not made this decision to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. And this morning you're saying, yes, Pastor, I want to, and I need to, so that I can live my life missionally for God. I want to be His child, His ambassador. I want to be a blessing to many and not waste my life on earth. If that's the cry of your heart, that's the desire of your heart, I want to lead you in a simple word of prayer. A prayer that you utter from your heart, even though I lead you to say, Jesus, come into my life. I need you. I need your help. I need you to change my heart. I need you to change my life. And He will come in if you are sincere in your cry to Him. So if you, wherever you are, perhaps, you know, someone is watching with you right now, you may want to lean over and say, would you like to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior now? If yes, I would join you in this prayer as Pastor Glen will lead us. And so bow your head, close your eyes, if you want to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior this time. Will you say these words to God? Say, Heavenly Father, I come to you in Jesus' name. I admit I'm a sinner. I've sinned against you. I've sinned against others. I ask you today, forgive me of all my sin as I repent before you. I believe Jesus came and died on the cross for my sin. I accept Jesus Christ now as my Lord and personal Savior. From this day on, I worship no other God but you alone. I willingly commit my life to you, Lord. So fill me with your Holy Spirit to live this new life as a child of God for your glory, for your honor. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. If you pray this prayer and really mean it with all your heart, now you may think that that's just a utterance of a few words called prayer. But is God really real? Yes, He is. Yes, He is. 42 years ago, I prayed a simple prayer like that. God came into my life and changed this rascal into a radical for Him. That's why I dare to say this God that we worship is real. And there's no other way to be saved but through Jesus Christ and Jesus alone. So if you have prayed this prayer, really meant it with all your heart, I want to say, welcome to the family of God. The Bible said, as many as confess Him as Lord, to them give power to become children of God. So congratulations for this decision you have made. Let me pray for you. Father, I pray for those who prayed this prayer and really meant it with all their heart. Father, break every yoke of bondage in their lives and set them completely free from the clutches of the evil one. Father, they may not fully understand everything right now, but Father, I ask you to reveal yourself to them that they know deep within their heart, you have forgiven them, you have cleansed them from their sin. And Lord, you have done a special work within them. And let them experience your peace that surpasses all understanding, that they know deep within, Lord, something has happened within their heart, within their life, within their spirit. Thank you, Father. I commit them into your loving hand for your will to be done, your purposes to be accomplished in and through their lives. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. If you have accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, if you're with family members or with friends, I'd like to encourage you to partake of communion with us together. This will be your first communion. And so family members, if they are with you or some friends, will you just serve them the elements also? Perhaps you are alone. Then the next time when we partake communion every first Sunday of the month, get ready the elements. You may not know what to do. Give us a call in the church office. Put a tick, you know, in our Facebook page. Or contact us through our website to let us know you make this important decision. And now what? We'd love to give you some good reading materials to help you in your walk with God. Amen. So for those of us who are partaking of communion right now, the bread you hold represents the body of our Lord Jesus Christ. His body was scourged, his body was broken, was tortured, was beaten, so that your body and mine today will be made whole. Amen. Especially for those of you who are sick right now, today will be your day of healing. Because the Bible said, according to your faith, so shall it be. Amen. So as you hold this bread in your hand, I'd like you to stand if you can, wherever you are, as you hold this bread in your hand, let's say this word to God. With our heart we believe, with our mouth we confess. So as you hold the bread, say this word. Ready? Go. Say, thank you, Father, for loving me and giving your Son to die on the cross for my sin. His body was broken so that mine will be made whole today. And today I believe that by his stripes, my body is healed, renewed, restored, and rejuvenated. In Jesus' name, I believe and I receive. Amen. Father, I stand believing with my brother and my sister as they trust in you and believe in you for their miracle, especially for their healing, for their breakthrough. Let it be so, Lord. And I would declare, be healed in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Let's partake of the bread together. The cup you hold this morning represents his blood. His blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary for your sin and my sin. And as he has forgiven you of your offenses, go and forgive others of their offenses to you. Don't hold any more anger, hatred, resentment, unforgiveness in your heart against those who have offended you. I know it's tough, but God will give you the strength to do it. As he has forgiven you, he expects you to forgive them. Because if not, then it's like you drinking poison and expecting your enemy to die. Hatred, unforgiveness, resentment, anger will destroy you. So let it go. Commit your enemies to God, those who have taken advantage of you, to God, and let God avenge for you. So as you hold this cup in your hand, say these words to God. Ready? Go. Father, I thank you for the precious blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, shed for my sin and redemption. Thank you for forgiving me and setting me free from sin, from guilt, from condemnation. Today, I forgive everyone who have offended me too. Thank you for making me righteous in your sight and for granting me eternal life. Anoint me and use me and make me a blessing to many. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Lord, I agree with my brother and my sister that you will touch them in your own special and powerful way as you empower them to shine for you, O God, to witness for you, to draw others into your kingdom by the power of your Holy Spirit. I pray, Lord, that as they live for you, as they prepare themselves for your soon coming, Lord, you will just, oh God, enlighten them. You will just empower them, and you will just lift up their spirit today, Lord. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. Let's drink together. Amen. Would you join me and give the Lord a good clap offering for what he has done in your life, even right now? Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. We love you. We worship you. We praise you. We adore you, Lord. We delight ourselves in you. No one can be compared with you at all. Truly, you're the great and mighty God. Hallelujah. 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 And we say, blessed be your name, Lord. Amen. Amen. Now, before we close, I just want to encourage you to, you know, make a mission pledge today. If you have not done so, the pledges will be for the next 5 months from August to December. And those of you who have already made a mission pledge, I'd like to encourage you to renew your mission pledges for August to December. And those of you who have not made any pledges yet, I encourage you, sow generously into the work of mission, into the kingdom of God, and watch what God will do. Because he says, you sow generously, you will reap generously also. So give a portion of what he has blessed your life with, you know, to the mission funds of Elim Church. Just a quick update for you. You know, in the last 6 months, despite the COVID-19 crisis and lockdown, you know, your mission money, that which you have given, has gone to support Bible school students, Bible school faculty and staff, you know, has gone to support children in orphanages, people in the drug rehab center, has gone to support local and overseas missionaries, evangelists, and itinerant workers, preachers. And has gone, your money has gone to support various mission work in China, in Hong Kong, in Indonesia, especially in Jakarta, Pontianak, Semarang, and Jogja. And also in Batam. Your money has gone to support mission work in Malaysia, in Nepal, in Japan, in Tokyo, in the Philippines, in Bacolod City, as well as in Silai City. And your money has gone to support mission works and missionaries in France, in Paris, in Uganda, in Vietnam, and of course here in Singapore. For this, I'm grateful that as a small church like Elim, that God can use us to touch so many lives all over the world. And so I encourage you to join us if you have not done so yet, to be a part of Elim Mission Outreach through your giving and your prayer. And you can give your mission money, your mission fund through the bank transfer or pay now, or even by check, but just state clearly four missions, all right? Four missions in your statement. Let me close in prayer. Throughout this week, remember to be joyful, to be prayerful, and to be thankful at all time, because this is God's will for us in Christ Jesus. So choose to live missionally for God. Choose to live holy and godly life for God. Have faith in Him and trust Him throughout this week to do the supernatural, the unthinkable, as well as the impossible for you and your family. Amen. And as God blesses you, go and be a blessing to somebody today and every day. Amen. Let's pray. Father, I'm just thankful for your presence here. And I pray the message that go forth will challenge your people to rise up and live the way that will be pleasing to you, O God, that will touch many lives for your kingdom. And as we leave now, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore. Amen. And all agree said, Amen. God bless you.